In this video, we go over two more series parallel problems where we're finding the REQ just to finish up this topic. And there's plenty of practice in the homework that's assigned from the text. So let's start with this problem here. We're asked for RAB, which is just the R equivalent between terminals AB. And you know, you can see here in the diagram that there are some resistors that are drawn in a diagonal fashion. And again, sometimes just that little thing can throw some people off. So let's see how we handle that as well as how we'll reduce this circuit. So first off, remember again, like we talked about last video, you can redraw a circuit, redraw the resistors as long as they're still connected to the same nodes after you redraw. It's the same circuit. So see, that's what was done here in this diagram. The 18 ohm resistor was just redrawn, so it's straight up and down instead of at an angle. And you see after it's drawn straight up and down, it's still connected to the same two nodes, top and bottom, as it was up in this circuit. And it's just easier when it's drawn like this, where it's vertical, to see for some people, again. Again, it's not necessary for all people to redraw, but you can see more clearly that the 18 and 9 are in parallel, as well as the 20 and 5 here is in parallel. So this next circuit shows both these parallel combinations reduced. So the 20 in parallel at 5 using product over sum, that's 100 divided by 25, that's 4 ohms. Okay, so that's where that 4 came from. And then if you do product over sum with 18 and 9, you get 6 ohms. So then the next thing that's done here is the 4 and the 1 are combined into a 5 ohm resistor, right? Because the 4 and 1 are in series. There's only a single path for current to flow through them. And then you have the 5 and the 20 in parallel, which is 4 again. And then that parallel combination is in series with this 2. So that's where the 6 comes from, okay, the 4 plus 2. And then the two sixes in parallel gives you 3, and then that parallel combination is in series with this 8. Because then it just becomes this last step here, that's just the last, it's a type of series or basic series parallel circuit like we talked about at the very beginning of this topic. So 8 plus 3, that's the final answer of 11 ohms. Let's look at this problem here. Okay, next. Now this problem's a little bit different than the other problems we've done in the videos, because this problem, you know, where we want to get the REQ is from the middle of the circuit. Okay, and all the problems we've done in the videos, now in the homework I'm sure there's problems like this, but as far as the videos go, the R equivalent was always at an N that we wanted the REQ for. But here we want to get the REQ from these two nodes that are in the middle of the circuit. Well, really no difference in the approach. I mean, again, just like if it was on the end, when the REQ is in the middle, you just want to start away from where you want the REQ from and work your way towards. So you see here, it's just we're working our way towards the middle as opposed to, you know, one end of a circuit. So down in this diagram here, some of the reductions have been done. See this resistor, 45 in parallel with 27 equaling 18 ohms, where that came from is combining the 30 and 24 that are in series, and now that 30 and 24 in series are in parallel with this 27. And then the 80 in parallel with 20, which equals 16, that came from combining the 50 and 30 here that are in series, and then that 80 is in parallel with this 20. So now, once you have these reductions, the 16 and the 14, right, just have one path. So they're in series, and then the 12 and 18 just have one path for current to flow between them, so they're in series. So we can we now have two 30 ohm resistors, and those 30 ohm resistors are in parallel, okay, because this series combination, the 14 and 16, and this series combination, the 18 and 12, they share the same two nodes. See how this node here has one side of this series combination and one side of this series combination connected? And then this node has the other side of this series combination and this series combination. So you see those two series combinations that equal up to 30 are both in parallel, and two 30 ohm resistors in parallel gives you 15. And then that 15 is in series with the two resistors that we have left between nodes A, B, and that's where your answer of 20 ohms comes from. So with what you've seen in our videos as far as solving these problems, and with the additional practice and the homework from the text, you should get to a point where hopefully you're fairly comfortable reducing resistors. Now, the next major topic of the quarter will be analyzing series parallel circuits, that have sources connected to them, and we're calculating voltages and currents, and once you have voltage and current, you can get power, and we'll be doing those problems utilizing techniques that we've learned up to this point, namely voltage divider equation, current divider equation, and KCL, KVL, Ohm's law.